वेलकम बच्चों, सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न रेस्पिरेशन इन प्लांट्स। आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू थिंक इट इज डिफिकल्ट चैप्टर, वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट, इजंट इट? एक्चुअली ये क्या है, ये सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन है। इट टेक्स प्लेस इन द सेल, ईच सेल ऑफ द प्लांट अंडरगोज दिस चेंज। व्हाट हैपेंस, वी गेट एनर्जी। एनर्जी कहाँ से मिलती है हमको? फूड से। We get energy from the food. In plants also the same thing. They also get energy from the food. Now here what happens? जब भी हम खाना खाते हैं वो खाना हमारे शरीर में digest होता है। Digest होने के बाद क्या क्या बनते हैं? हम protein खाते हैं, हम carbohydrates खाते हैं, हम lipids खाते हैं, बहुत सारे चीजें खाते हैं। We take lot of things and they undergo oxidation, the cellular oxidation. The cellular oxidation produces energy. Okay, so we continue from here. Respiration in plants. Energy comes from sunlight. We all know that energy comes from sunlight. The plants prepare their food from sunlight by photosynthesis. दिस फूड, ये जो खाना बना फोटोसिंथेसिस के द्वारा, वो एनिमल्स लोग खाते हैं। एनिमल्स लोग खाने के बाद वो खाना क्या होता है? प्लांट्स ऑल्सो डू द सेम थिंग, दे ऑल्सो अंडर गो, दे ऑल्सो ऑक्सीडाइज द फूड। एनिमल्स ऑल्सो ऑक्सीडाइज द फूड टू गेट एनर्जी। सो वॉट हैपन्स टू दिस प्लांट? द लीव्स फॉल ऑफ फ्रॉम द प्लांट, पत्ते झड़ जाते हैं, फिर पेड़ पौधे जब उनके जब सेनेसेंस हो जाती है, जब ओल्ड एज हो जाती है, तो वो मर जाते हैं। प्लांट्स भी डेथ होती है, उनकी भी डेथ होती है। तो आफ्टर डेथ व्हाट हैपेंस टू दिस प्लांट्स? द डिकम्पोजर्स विल गेट देयर फूड फ्रॉम दिस प्लांट्स, विल गेट देयर एनर्जी फ्रॉम दिस प्लांट्स, दे विल ऑल्सो ऑक्सीडाइज दिस फूड टू फॉर्म एनर्जी। तो ये बात है, फूड अंडरगोज ऑक्सीडेशन, ऑक्सीडेशन कॉजेज ब्रेक डाउन ऑफ द फूड एंड दैट इज सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन। ये जो फूड ब्रेक डाउन होते हैं ऑक्सीडेशन के सहारे, वो हर एक सेल में होते हैं, हर एक सेल में। इट टेक्स प्लेस इन एवरी सेल, दिस इज कॉल्ड सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन। What are the different types of food that we eat? I just now said carbohydrates, fats, proteins, organic acids, many things. So, carbohydrates, mainly glucose. One molecule of glucose, suppose ek molecule, glucose ka ek molecule liya, uska lysis hua. Lysis matlab breakdown. The breakdown of glucose is known as glycolysis. Glyco means glucose, lysis means breakdown. After undergoing lysis, they form two molecules of pyruvic acid are formed. These two molecules of pyruvic acid are formed at the end of glycolysis. Now this pyruvic acid has got two different chances. They either undergo aerobic respiration in presence of oxygen, or they undergo anaerobic respiration in absence of oxygen. So aerobic माने oxygen को लेकर और anaerobic माने oxygen ना लेकर। Oxygen लेकर, after taking oxygen, what happens? They form acetyl coenzyme A. This is actually a gateway reaction. Forming acetyl coenzyme A from pyruvic acid using oxygen is known as gateway reaction. And that which is not taken means anaerobic respiration. The anaerobic respiration causes two things. Either they, due to anaerobic respiration, they form ethyl alcohol, ethanol. Either they form ethanol or they form lactic acid or lactate. The lactic acid or lactate takes place in our muscle cells, and ethanol takes place in most of the fungus, yeast, etc. This is called
if ethanol is formed, this is called alcoholic fermentation, and if it forms lactic acid, it is called lactic acid fermentation. So we were talking about energy. So energy by anaerobic respiration during fermentation, they produce less than 7% of energy. If 13% of energy is produced in case during fermentation, if 13% of energy is produced and yeast dies ultimately, so much of alcohol can kill yeast colonies. Now this energy can be divided into three types. तीन तरह के हो सकते हैं, तीन रकमें होते पारे. एक होच्छे डायरेक्ट एटीपी हो सकता है, एनएडीएच फॉर्म में हो सकता है या एफएडीएच2 फॉर्म में हो सकता है. इट कैन बी डायरेक्ट एटीपी और एनएडीएच, जेटा तीन टे कोरे एटीपी दे, थ्री एटीपीज, ईच एनएडीएच गिव्स थ्री एटीपी एंड ईच एफएडीएच2 गिव्स टू एटीपी. नाउ ड्यूरिंग ग्लाइकोलाइसिस द टोटल एनर्जी, what is the total energy during glycolysis? Glycolysis, I told you, glycolysis means breakdown of glucose. It takes place in the cell cytoplasm. Glycolysis takes place in the cell cytoplasm. There are two types of phosphorylation taking place in the whole reaction, in this whole respiration reaction. One is substrate level phosphorylation, another is oxidative phosphorylation. Substrate level phosphorylation means it does not use the ETS, electron transport system, it doesn't use. That means NADH and FADH2 are not necessary, they are useless. Now here, during glycolysis, the used ATP is 2, 2 ATPs are used. ATPs produced, direct ATP produced are 4, and there are 2 NADH produced. That means, if 2 NADH produced means there are 2 into 3 ATPs, means 6 ATPs. So what is the net gain? This is 6. So 6 plus 4 minus 2. This is used. So this is minus. Net gain of ATP is equal to 6 plus 4 minus 2. That is equal to 8 ATP. During glycolysis, 8 ATP are produced, means 8 ATP are gained. Net ATP gain is equal to this, according to oxidative phosphorylation. Now, without this, in case of substrate level phosphorylation, what happens? Substrate level phosphorylation, what happens during this? Now since NADH2 produced is 2, we don't require this. 2 is used and 4 is produced. So 4 minus 2, we get 2 ATP in case of substrate level phosphorylation. Now what is glycolysis? The process of glycolysis starts from glucose. Now glucose is a 6 carbon compound. It breaks down to form glucose 6 phosphate, that is also a 6 carbon compound. From it, it forms fructose 6-phosphate, that is also a 6-carbon compound. These are isomers of each other. Now, it again adds up 1-phosphate, that means fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, it is also a 6-carbon compound. Now, this thing gets divided into two types. One is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, that is a 3-carbon compound. Another is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, that is a 3-carbon compound. Now, the same thing, whatever is produced here, it is produced here also. Both the sides are similar. That's why I have used this 2 into 2 into 2, means 2 each. One from here, one from here. One from here, one from here, like this. So glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate means G3P gives rise to 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid, that is a 3-carbon compound. That gives you 3-phosphoglyceric acid, 1-phosphate goes off, that is also a 3-carbon compound. From 3-phosphoglyceric acid, we come to 2-phosphoglyceric acid, that is a 3-carbon compound. From this, we get phosphoenolpyruvic acid, that means PEP, that is also a 3-carbon compound. And finally, we get pyruvic acid, that is a 3-carbon compound. So ultimately, we get 2 molecules of pyruvic acid from one molecule of glucose. That is glycolysis. So, very fast revision of glycolysis is like this. Glucose 6-phosphate, fructose 6-phosphate, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. From there we get G3P and DHAP. From there we get 1,3-bisphosphoglyceric acid, from there 3-phosphoglyceric acid, from there 2-phosphoglyceric acid, from there phosphoenolpyruvic acid PEP, from there we get pyruvic acid. Now this pyruvic acid undergoes a gateway reaction. This gateway reaction, here we get 2-NADH. During gateway reaction means conversion of pyruvic acid into acetyl coenzyme A. How does it occur? How does this conversion takes place? Means pyruvic acid gains a coenzyme A and releases a carbon dioxide. One carbon dioxide releases means one carbon gone. That means 3 carbon minus 1 carbon, we get 2 carbon compound over here, that is acetyl coenzyme A. This is a link reaction between glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Acetyl coenzyme A is a 2 carbon compound. It reacts with 4 carbon compound which is already present in mitochondrial matrix. Now from oxaloacetic acid it forms citric acid, that is a 6 carbon, 4 plus 2 makes 6. From there isocitric acid, that is a 6 carbon compound. From there we get a carbon dioxide is released, that means 1 carbon is released, we get 5 carbon compound alpha ketoglutaric acid. Here 1-NADH is released, here also second part 1-NADH is released and 1 carbon dioxide is again released. So 5 minus 1 is 4 carbon compound, this one. This is succinic acid. During this conversion, another NADH is produced. Now succinic acid, when it is converted into malic acid, 1-FADH2 is produced. 1-FADH2 produced means here we get 2-ATP. Here we get 3-ATP. Here we get 3-ATP. And here again, from malic acid to oxaloacetic acid, both are 4 carbon compounds, we again get 1-NADH, that means 3-ATP. So how many ATPs are produced over here? 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 3, 11. Okay, so another thing, direct ATP, how much direct ATP is produced during this? Direct ATP produced is 2. 2 ATPs are produced direct over here, 2. In Krebs cycle, 2 ATPs are directly produced. 2-FADH2, I told you there are 2 circles taking place, one from here, another from DHAP. So, here 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus 3 means 9, 9 plus 2, 11. 11 2s are 22. Okay. That means 2 ATPs in total, one from here, one from other circle, 2-FADH2, one from here, another from another circle. Now, total over here is then how much? 2 from direct ATP, that means 2. 2 from FADH2, that means 2 2s are 4, 6 from NADH2, that means 6 3s are 18. So how many total? 18 plus 4, 22, 22 plus 2, 24. 24 ATPs are produced from Krebs cycle. 24 ATPs produced from Krebs cycle, and in glycolysis we have said that 8 ATPs are produced, and in gateway reaction we get how much? In gateway reaction we get 2 NADH2. 2 NADH2 means 2 into 3, that means 6. So 24 plus 6 is 30 and glycolysis is 8. Glycolysis 8. 8 ATPs. Krebs cycle. ATP. And link reaction or gateway reaction. Gateway reaction we get 6 ATPs. That means total 38 ATPs of energy are produced in aerobic respiration. Thank you. So if you like this video, please share it with your friends and kindly subscribe the channel. Thank you.